Many times when I interview an MMA star and post the videos and zoom in on their face, there's always someone who makes comments about their ear, because usually when you're an MMA fighter, you're gonna have cauliflower ears. Check it out.
Yeah.
Does that hurt?
When it happens, it does. Not now. It's hard now. But when it happens, it hurts.
Yeah.
It swells up a whole lot before it gets to, see, it's hard now, but before it gets to this, it's all swollen and black and blue and
real
filled with fluid and blood, and then it hardens up and it turns into cartilage. You can't feel it now, but before, it hurts.
You're not going to fix it until you're done with your career.
Right, exactly, because it just happened again. So
whenever I see someone with ears like that, I know they're MMA, right?
A wrestler that's gone over to MMA. Not all MMA fighters have ears like this.
Yeah, like he doesn't.
What?
His ears, they're not kind of low.
No, the ladies don't like it too much, so every time it bubbles up, I gotta.
Is that true? The ladies don't like it?
It's true.
Ladies make fun of it, but I mean, like, good Brad here, he gets the ladies no matter what, so, cauliflower or not.
So take it into consideration if you're considering a career as an MMA fighter, a boxer, or a wrestler, cauliflower ears. If it was me, I would drain it every time it would get swell up. But each one does it their own way. In Los Angeles, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.